Hey, what's going on to all the Wrestle Pals? I see you got the pro wrestling potluck coming up. Well, first of all, man, when you eat potluck, is that just food and drinks? Is that like different type of girls or different type of sexual things? Or, man, I don't know. Potluck to me can mean a lot of wild and crazy things. But I see you guys are getting together. You like to watch pay-per-views and watch matches and promos. Dude, if you guys could go back and really catch some of the stuff that the Godfather used to say, or Val Venus. People always complained about me, but dude, Val Venus was really out there. And you guys are 420. Well, that means, you know what? Where's this wrestling potluck at? Maybe I should show up, because if I show up, I'm gonna bring hoes, I'm gonna bring weed, I'm gonna bring a good motherfucking time. So you guys enjoy the pro wrestling potluck. Excuse me, I smoke a lot. I wish I was there, man. And like I said, try to catch out some of those old promos, and if you're high, you'll laugh your ass off, because I was high every time I did one. So it's time, once again, for everybody, including everybody at WrestlePals, to come aboard the Ho Train. Keep it pimping, keep it smoking. Potluck, let's get it done.
Working. Is it Thursday? Yes, yes, yes. Uh-oh, it's time for the Pro Wrestling Potluck. I am your host, Scotland Green, aka Booger Green. They call me Willard Scotland on your birthday. Squawk McKenzie, Scott Doggy Dog, Scottish Bulldog, Sad Dog Buzz Sawyer, Bobby Brain Fog Heenan, and then and on and on and on. Welcome to Pro Wrestling Potluck. This is a live weekly wrestling mixtape where I take submissions from you, the viewers, and I hold on to them and I deal them out in fun ways. Sometimes they're full gimmick episodes, like next week's Labor Day episode. More on that later. But usually they're just kind of fun shows that wind their way through many different styles and eras of wrestling, and a theme might come. You might see somebody once or twice and be like, hey, it's Jerry Jarrett again or whatever. You know what I mean? So that's what we got, and we're going to get right into it because I wasted time up top trying to get my shit together. So we're going to go into it right now. We got something from the Buzz Bin. If you guys don't know a Buzz Bin, that's where we get our hot matches that people are talking about. I go to the Buzz Bin like we used to do back in the day when you wanted a CD that you liked. You went to MTV's Buzz Bin. Well, now come to the Potluck Buzz Bin, and we'll start it off now. Let's hit that, roll that Buzz Bin footage.
In the future, everything will be simple. With just a look and a thought, anything can be yours. Looking further. Deeper. Longer. Into the buzz.
All right, that's our new Buzz Bin stinger that I made that I'm so proud of. All right, let's get right into it with our first match. We got sound. Oh, we got double sound. That's my fault.
And we've made it to the main event. Let's send it down to Nadia for the introductions.
Okay. Getting echoed sound again like I did last time. Not sure why. Let's see if I can.
Standing at 7'4", Andrew the Giant Everett!
I think if I fix my sound real quick, we're going to lose sound for a second, but I think it will be for the greater good. It's not for the greater good. All right. Did you lose sound? I bet you did. Let's see if you get it back.
I'm fired up. I'm fired up. All James right. is fired up. It's main event time, baby. It's time to believe the damn hype.
Their main event is our opening match. How about that? Isn't that nice?
He is a giant. He's
damn right. You're damn right. He's a giant.
Super tall. Very tall. Let's see if we can get that handshake here between the two.
Okay, I take this.
Takeshita and Everett. And there it is.
There's the respect. Now all we have to do is hear the bell.
Oh my.
Let's go.
Went for the get. Chokeslam.
Takeshita.
Backflips out of it. Everett. Oh my God. Leapfrog from Takeshita.
Getting right
Everett
into it.
Hands, springing off over and under. Blue Thunder. No. Goes through.
Oh man.
Let's see if these feature this chats are only supposed to be around for a few seconds. During the pre-show, I had one hang around and around, and I don't know what to do about
right
that.
Now. What a special time this is. Andrew Everett, Konosuke Takeshita, as we saw right there. This is not going to be an easy takeover for either man.
I don't know if you saw that Everett went for the collar and elbow. Takeshita just grabbing his left arm there, snatching him up to get into this position. Everett up and down. Snapmare rolls him through, and Everett is now on top.
Taking the head in control here. Very smart. Takeshita looking to break that grip.
I mean,
he gets him over into a top.
I have a feeling this is like a dark prediction, but I think I could see Takeshita being signed by Triple H's WWE. Right? I could see it. Seems like a major player that a guy like Triple H would want to invest in.
Takeshita can throw bombs.
Oh no.
Oh.
You didn't have to do that to that man. The crowd coming alive once again. How many times is Takeshita going to get a stand?
Get in the chat here if you've never watched before. The chat is so much fun. It's the
truly one of the best in the world.
The sideshow.
Oh, Everett, back elbow.
That
off the
makes
ropes.
The
Takeshita
show
really
better.
On the apron, goes high and hits him with another blow.
Yeah, these
to the
feature
side of
chats.
The Everett,
they're sticking
the
around.
Apron.
I got to figure out how to edit these feature chats.
Thinking,
what do you mean
is
move?
Is he thinking suplex?
I don't think that. I don't want to think that. Don't think that. Stop thinking that.
He's got the waist right now.
Please don't die. That's one of our top chants, ladies and gents.
Oh, man. Takeshita just sends him right down. That forearm right to the side of the head. Everett trying to get back on his feet. Takeshita grabs his head. Everett springboards off the top.
Drop. That was almost real nasty, but Takeshita lands on his feet.
Taking a little rest in one of those chairs. I think he noticed right away.
There's no rest when Andrew Everett's around. Everett up and over the top. Saw Takeshita kick to the side of the head.
Yeah, these little feature chats shouldn't be hanging around this long. I gotta figure that out. Oh! Ever seen a giant do an acai moonsault?
Six chairs there.
That's all right. That's about like 20 chairs tonight. Sorry, no problem.
Andrew Everett has got to get him back into the ring here. That's the only way to win this matchup.
Everett grabbing Takeshita by the back of his head, looking to send him back in, just as you were saying, James, rolls him in, but I think Everett knows he's got to do a little more than that.
He's a giant, fun chant.
He's so agile, off the top, shotgun drop kick off the top again from Andrew Everett, and he covers him. One, two, no.
Kick out there from Takeshita.
Got a good seltzer today. Today we're drinking Trader Joe's cranberry clementine. Cranberry clementine, which is a Grateful Dead song, I believe.
I mean, Andrew Everett's a giant, but Takeshita's a very
sip of seltzer for the working man.
Knee into the back, very smart move there by Andrew Everett. Sends him down and drops the elbow.
Ooh, this is a good seltzer. Clementine and cranberries, two great tastes.
I don't know how often you see him just drop the elbow like that, trying to keep Takeshita.
You got
down,
clementine and my cranberry. Cranberry and my clementine.
Off Takeshita as he's firing off with these shots.
Ooh, dropped Owen, able to catch him there.
And he kips up.
Oh.
To the side of the head. The
tagged
ear of
him
Takeshita
in the
discombobulating. One, two, no.
Two count only.
Going straight for the pin there. You can tell how urgent.
Ooh,
Andrew,
it's a good seltzer. Let's get that.
Grabs his hair. A headbutt. A headbutt from Andrew Everett. He has thrown everything he can at Takeshita. Everett stepping up to his feet, dragging Takeshita up. What's he got in mind? Oh,
we got a lot of fun stuff planned tonight. This might not be our only trip to the buzz bin, folks.
Why are they so loud? Why do they sound like that? Got another one. Takeshita driving it home once again. You know that's got to be cramping up on the left side of Everett's neck.
Dave Seltzer.
Wait,
Drew's fighting back here. Look at this.
Can you imagine the heat? Dave Seltzer? I'd have to get big arms.
Takeshita sending one in. Takeshita go behind, lifting up the giant back elbows from Everett. Takeshita catches him by his gear, lifts him up, spins him around.
Oh, wow, did you see his head bounce off the mat there? Takeshita just using all the power he has.
Face first off the canvas. Takeshita sends him off the ropes. Now here comes Everett up and the height.
I'm about to re-up on my SodaStream CO2, and then it's over. Then I'm buying grapefruit juice, pure grapefruit juice, to mix with seltzer.
Everett, what's he got in mind here?
It's gonna be good times.
Repeated shots.
It's gonna be good times when that happens.
Everett gets sent off the ropes. No, Takeshita off the ropes instead. Ducks the line. Takeshita has a fire.
Whoa, the speed.
Takeshita. Huge line, sending Everett down. And Everett is reeling. Takeshita feeling it. You can feel he's got this in the bag. Momentum has shifted from the giant to Takeshita. Big elbow in the corner. Everett sent off. Everett reverses the whip once again. Takeshita hits the buckle, goes for a lariat, goes for another DDT on Everett.
He's got to get the pin here.
One, two, oh. Not just yet.
Tell
James
me about
Takeshita.
These bubbles.
Able, or not, I don't know if he would
these blokes
on
and
that.
Their bubbles.
Didn't hook the leg deep enough, but those moves, those series of moves were
it was like
dangerous.
One day Brian Alvarez right just started calling people blokes. Just started saying blokes.
I can
conscious
never
decision.
What comes next with Takeshita. He has so many moves in his arsenal, so many ideas in his head. He's dragging Andrew Everett over these chairs. Over
whoa.
We are just...
These guys are going on a trip.
Here.
Lots of open space back here. The boys are selling their merch.
About earlier, James, the cogs moving,
some are
the
standing
spin.
There watching
Takeshita
the match.
Has something in mind. Oh. Oh! Did you hear how loud that was? His head just bounced
the announcer
off that metal ring
squealed
post.
When they
that
heard
metal
the
right there. Yeah,
metal upon
up,
flesh.
Especially if he can't get a hold of this match right now. Andrew Everett just firing off fists at him right now.
Suzanne
right
also says, Bubbly Marshall.
Here. Punching him in the head. Everett now on the apron.
Bubbly Marshall.
This is a dangerous place for either man to be. You never want to land on the apron. I mean, landing on the ring mat itself, the
down.
Canvas.
You never know.
Hurts enough. Hitting that
you
ring
never know.
Hard enough.
I don't write
but
down enough
apron,
of these.
The deadliest part of a ring. Oh, no.
Oh, I missed it. I was looking down to write Bubbly Marshall down.
Twerking.
That's what I get.
Apron.
You almost saw him go straight up and down.
God. What does Takeshita have in mind here? Moving the front row out of the way?
Uh-oh. I love when a wrestler puts
right
another
now,
wrestler in a chair.
Seat,
just
Andrew
sets
Everett's
him
case.
Down like
Takeshita
he's a
looking to clear the entire
a,
length
a
of the
problem
ring.
Drunk. Oh, whoa. Oh, lifted him
right
out of the seat with a boot.
Like he was in the air.
Good God. He lifted him off the seat with his boot.
That's exactly what I said.
That's some scary strength there from Konosuke Takeshita as he sends Everett back into the ring. And he rolls him over. That might be it. One, two.
Two.
And Wiggins only calling for a two here.
Takeshita, when he went over top of him, his body wasn't connecting. It left room for Drew to get that right hand up there. That's exactly what he did. Takeshita trying to follow up and slow things back down.
Had that cravat and snapped him over, trying to just cinch up any body part that he can. You see he has that left leg locked over Everett's left arm.
How's the sound for everybody? Right arm, is though, the sound okay?
Trying to separate Takeshita's grip. Ooh. But that, look at those biceps on this guy, man. Squeezing and squeezing at Everett's head.
Takeshita was a professional bodybuilder. And you can see right now, I mean, look at his body
sound
up here.
Sound is goof.
This guy definitely hits the weight.
Sound is goof.
Everett throwing shots in the midsection, firing off a shot to the neck.
Oh! He didn't even have a chance to recoil. His body just fell backwards on the mat, almost like a log.
How does Takeshita have that much power in his strikes this far into this matchup? Everett's out in the corner. Here comes Takeshita. Everett moves just barely, though. Going for a northern lariat. Everett, uppercut, plants perfectly under the jaw of Takeshita.
I haven't seen Takeshita a lot of Everett. I'm liking what I'm seeing.
Uses double boost.
I know he does the giant gimmick.
Back, goes high. Everett up and around and plants him. Everett getting hit with a DDT or two earlier. You saw one on the apron, one in the ring from Takeshita. Turnabout is fair play. That tilt-a-whirl DDT spiking Takeshita on his head.
Both men are down. Someone has got to find the ability to stand up right now.
Both men showing signs of life, raising their fist to the sky, trying to get the crowd to rally behind them. Big, deep breaths from Takeshita. Same for Andrew Everett. Wiggins on the count, standing 10. Takeshita on a knee. Everett on his feet. And he... Is he? Oh my God!
Here we go.
Choke slam from the giant!
Yosuke's got a goozle of his own.
Look at the face.
Thinking choke slam.
Everett's hand is fading. He doesn't have the grip. Takeshita choke
He's
slam.
Got him.
Go behind from Everett. Oh, throws misdirection off the deadlock rope. Up and around.
I didn't realize Everett had been around that long.
Dumps him 1-2. No. Did you see Everett caught in the air? Not only caught in the air by Takeshita, but Takeshita was able to readjust all of Everett's weight. Perfect positioning to dump him down for that Blue Thunder Bomb.
Any other night against any other opponent, that would have been it. But here at the main event of DPW, Believe the Hype, Andrew Everett, no way.
Takeshita's got his arms all wrapped up here, both behind his back, trying to spin him around here. Everett, headbutt, perfect placement. You see Takeshita reeling. Everett going for another shot, goes high. Takeshita shoves him into the buckle. Over the top, maybe looking for that Everett special. No, goes low midsection. Blocks a shot from Takeshita. Big kick to the side of the head. Takeshita's reeling. Here comes the big dog off the top. Spin wheel kick.
Wow. Spinning wheel kick.
Off the top. Everett just taking him down. I mean, the body control you have to be able to not only springboard off that top rope, but to get yourself in a position to hit that spin wheel kick. Unbelievable. It looks like he's going for it again.
Back in position here, Andrew Everett off that springboard.
The second one.
He hits it again.
Damn.
That is unbelievable.
Takeshita's not even
Worked
staying
once.
Down.
Why not
get him
try
over
it
to
again?
His back to get the pin. You can see Everett looking back over, and you just keep seeing him get back up.
Everett trying to get up. Is he going for a third here? He is.
Going through the third time. The rule of threes.
Faithful.
Come on,
here
my
comes
man.
The giant off the top. Springboard up, and nobody's home.
Forward roll.
Yakuza kick.
That fired him up. The big man.
Ooh. Off the second.
A little double moonsault.
Lion Salt nails it.
Connects.
That upper combination. 1-2.
Just a two. A Takeshita able to find that just in time. That could have been it.
I have no clue how Everett has that kind of energy left in him, not only springing off the rope to take down Takeshita with that moonsault, but then the lion salt that followed up after. It's classic Everett, but it impresses me every time, and I know Takeshita was entirely caught off guard by that. Everett with wrist control for a moment there.
Lost
both men
it.
Getting back up. Back on their feet. The stare down. The Goozle.
Oh, big Goozle block.
Ooh, almost took his head off.
Goozle!
Re-Goozle!
Everett, choke!
What? Up and over.
How? Oh, my God! No. Just drills him with it!
How many more can one man take?
He kills him with it! He grabs Everett!
Let's go! To catch the fire!
Rolling elbow, no! Enziguri from Everett. Everett smacking the mat, trying to find that last bit of energy he has deep inside of him. The giant, poised and ready, off the rope.
Turned him inside out. His socks are on his.
Are you kidding me?
One count this late in the game. Holy shit, chant. These fans love to swear. Holy shit, this shit fucks.
I can't believe it. Uh-oh.
I need to put my grandson to bed.
He's got him in his sights. Oh, missed the knee. Ever from behind. Up and over. Takeshita. Three-way kick from Everett.
He's wobbling.
Goozle.
He's got that Goozle.
Everett's got him.
That's it.
1-2.
On their feet.
This is unbelievable. This
what an
is
opening contest.
Truly incredible here. And
I was almost
going to
put this in the middle of the show,
top.
But I thought let's start with our buzz bin.
Man. What's he got in mind here? Takeshita's down. He's trying to get up, but he can't. Toad! Toad! Oh! Plus! 1-2!
No! No way!
Takeshita is in the fight! There is no quit in either man! This is DPW! Takeshita on the apron.
Ooh, fight forever. We don't like that one.
If there was anyone that could, it is these two.
This crowd is unbelievable.
Takeshita just bare. The only thing holding him up is the ropes. And Everett sees him. He's heading over towards him. What could possibly be left, man? How do these men have anything left in the tank? What a shot. Takeshita, those powerful forearm strikes. But Everett, oh, he's dragging Everett up with him. Going to the top here, everyone waiting, bated breath as these men ascend to the top of the Holzhauser building. Oh, what a shot it sends Everett right back down to the canvas. What has Takeshita got in mind from up top?
He got right
Everett.
Back up.
Oh.
Kick to the ear. What is going on here? Both men up top. Everett in control for the top. Chokeslam.
Oh, no. Goozle.
Chokeslam from Everett.
Goozle this high in the sky.
Where is he going? Where is he going? Wait, what?
Whoa! That's it.
Lariat!
Huge top rope lariat.
That's the same move he beat Adam Brooks with.
One,
saw him beat Adam Brooks with that. We watched
no
that in the buzz bin,
here
folks.
From Konosuke Takeshita.
Oh.
1, 2.
There you go. Wow.
And here's your winner, Konosuke Takeshita.
I don't know if we have ever seen anything quite like that in the history of Deadlock Pro Wrestling. Konosuke Takeshita and Drew Everett, two of the best in the entire world, doing it right here in DPW.
Yay! And that's our opening match, and that's a buzz bin, folks!
In the future, everything will be simple. With just a look and a thought, anything can be yours. Looking further. Deeper. Longer. Into the buzz.
There you go. That's our buzz bin match this week, at least one of them, and let's get right
okay,
back to it.
Okay, thanks to Mean Gene Okerlund and fans. Let's take you back to when Vader attacked Steamboat right here on Saturday night.
Uh-oh, I heard the words Ricky Steamboat. This could only mean one thing. This is a submission from the great Andrew Heelan. Dude, Vader in street clothes is very scary. It's like a side-scrolling beat-em-up villain. It's some Final Fight. Double Dragon. Double Ricky the Dragon. Beating the shit out of him 3 weeks ago. Well,
ladies
here
and
we are.
The following feature confrontation. It is set for one fall. Introducing first from Charlotte, North Carolina, weighing 200.
Very good question. Did he? We got to find this one out.
Ladies and gentlemen, his opponent to be accompanied to the ring by former heavyweight champion Harley Race. He's from the Rocky Mountains.
I'm not sure
weighing
when this is from.
450 pounds. Peter.
Watch out, Bob. He took our chairs.
He can have it. He can have a towel. He can have whatever he wants.
Thumbs down. For Vader.
Come on. Let's see what Vader's doing.
Well, wait a minute.
See a bunch of punks with posters?
Hey, those books, if you will, they are salary. And Harley Race trying to calm Vader down, but he's throwing chairs everywhere.
Well, just like the fireball was shooting out of Steamboat, can you imagine the raging inferno inside of Vader?
And we'll find out that raging inferno, the match in its entirety after this timeout on TBS. Stay with us.
You're going to fire signature, Andy.
What's cool?
Oh.
What's hot?
We get the commercials?
Awesome on you.
I don't know how I feel
WCW
about this.
Wear.
Whoa.
That's right. We're going to make you look good with the new official WCW wear.
This stuff is excellent.
Oh, yeah.
We've got t-shirts, sweatshirts, hats, shirts, and more. Cool clothes for all ages. WCW Wear.
Where?
Right
where?
Here. To order your WCW Wear, get the catalog by calling toll-free 1-800-4-WCW now.
Open sesame.
Whoa.
Hey, Joe.
Holy shit.
We're down to the last Butterfinger.
The last Butterfinger!
Why does the animation in this look 100 times better than the show looks now?
Crunchity, peanut,
like, this looks great. Looks like it has some style.
Nobody better lay a finger on my Butterfinger.
After most meals and snacks, plaque pH can fall to levels where acid starts attacking teeth.
Plaque pH.
These attacks can last up to 2 hours. Increasing the risk of damage to gum can help. Saliva. So you make...
Good Lord. Hey now.
Walking Tall Part 2 and the final chapter
Walking Tall Part 2.
10:35 Eastern Sunday on TBS.
How much should I fast forward?
Discretion advised.
Next on TBS, Mookie and the Hearts are ready to take on the Sixers in live NBA
Mookie
action.
And the Hearts.
Coming up next right here on TBS.
All right, there we go. Sorry about that commercial interruption. I did not foresee that.
Steamboat, a great competitor. The elbow.
Mookie and the Hawks.
I don't think it's going to help him much with a man the size of Vader.
Mookie and the Hawks.
Holly Race gets down.
I'm Mookie, and I'm also the Hawks. Oh.
Race goes out. Close to a disqualification.
Whoa, right over the top rope. Both land on their feet.
All the anger from 3 weeks ago. That was amplified when Steamboat tried to get in the cage to help Flair.
Ooh.
Have a seat.
Wow.
The chair. And again.
Wow. Chair's just wrapped around the big head. Vader tumbles.
He should be disqualified.
Hey, I think he deserves it, really. As the argument continues with Ray.
Chris Hero, I've only watched one of his streams. But I check out the things that he has streamed. He has a good playlist of things he has streamed. And I have taken some things from that playlist. It's a good collection. Wow, Vader's out.
But you got to keep control. Get down. Make that ref turn around. Steamboat hit Vader, what, 6, 7, 8 times with a chair. No call for that.
Whoop, there it is, Chad.
Kind of man he is.
Oh, my God. Most well, now you know exactly when this is. Oh, my God. I'm popping for Ricky Steamboat saying, whoop, there it is. I like that this isn't the first time. Whoa. The first time in a potluck that... Whoop, there it is, has come up. Whoa! That's a fucking cool chop. Overhand.
Oh, you like that, huh? From behind.
Oh, Harley.
Race is holding on to Steamboat.
The ref didn't see. To be fair, the ref was tucking his shirt back in. He didn't see that interference.
Oh, he is something. Steamboat, if you're smart, go back to the dressing room.
And Race drives the foot in to the chest and throat region.
All I want to do is watch 94 WCW. That's the conclusion that I've come to.
Drives the knee into the forehead.
When I put these potlucks together, I have to dial back the amount of mid-90s WCW. Because I missed this stuff. I wasn't watching this at the time. I was watching their competition. And this stuff is great.
Vader now.
I'm talking about a nice restaurant.
Oh, yeah, a nice one.
My first draft of potlucks are always like 3 hours long, and then I got to figure out what I'm going to take out.
The power of Vader. It was almost like a suplex where he just threw him back in the ring.
He threw him into a different zip code.
And now Vader
after being beaten with a chair, thanks to Harley Race now on the outside. This mammoth athlete is back. Uh-oh, here we go. The place you do not want to be. And Flair,
oh,
can tell you,
oh, there's those punches.
See, he's not really hitting.
Love them corner punches from Big Van Vader. The green cut. Release the green cut.
The mind of Vader right now certainly is thinking about
it's like I could do a 3-hour show, but I don't think anyone would want to watch it. I feel like it would be I would have, I mean, I already have people come in and out, but I feel like it would be even more so if I had a longer show.
Just beat on that meter maid. I'll tell you, if I was Steamboat, I'd take Vader.
You take Vader?
No, I take the elevator.
The elevator.
Oh my God.
Get out of here. Nick Weiss. Look at the size of his hands, how it wraps around the face of Steamboat.
But that's good, though, because tomorrow Steamboat will be able to look into his breast pocket without even moving his head. Maybe his back pocket, too.
There he is, Vader, on the middle turnbuckle.
Steamboat wants to beat him so bad. Steamboat wants to be WCW champion again. I wonder sometimes.
It'd be fun to do a long show for, like, a gimmick or some kind of reason. Potluck Lockin.
Came in with that nightstick. He had had enough of Vader trying to hurt Ric Flair. Of course, he had been handcuffed. And the Boss taking justice into his own hands. Certainly, the wrath of Vader.
He had one of those Cobo Hall nightsticks. See that one on the extender?
Yes.
Vader getting ready to do
middle
something. Taking his damn
Vader.
Time.
Steamboat's up. He's dazed.
Whoa! Vader, you don't. Wait, shouldn't that have been the other way around?
He's not going for a pin.
Vader's doing Steamboat moves, and Steamboat's countering the way Vader might. Ooh.
What is wrong with Steamboat? Slapping Vader around like a dog.
Incredible.
You're just going to make him mad, Steamboat.
Yeah.
You're going to see another fireball come out of you, but it won't be your mouth.
Well, I would agree with that.
Not sure what that means, but oh,
Steamboat got the chop down just
big chop, another big chop.
And now Steamboat again up top.
Oh, there it is.
With Vader all the time. You can do it another guy 240, 50, 60 pounds, but not as big as Vader.
God, I want to start a Whoop There It Is chant on every show. I'm going to go to HOG on Sunday and start a Whoop There It Is chant.
Fans thought he had it, but he didn't. A two count.
For Eddie Kingston versus Mara Fuji.
Steamboat in a chop.
I guarantee you the Boss is watching this.
Steamboat sending Vader up.
But will he remember anything? You know, his retention span is about 11 seconds.
There's Harley Race up as well. Watch out here.
Ooh.
Steamboat has him up.
But he didn't get him good.
He couldn't really pick him up. That's all he could do with a 450-pound man. Steamboat! Flying body press! He's got him!
The got big him hooked.
Ref.
The referee,
Jesus
two.
Christ, no, referee!
He may have beaten the man, and it had not been for Harley Race.
Steamboat, remember.
Oh, good.
Whoop, there it is.
Oh, no.
You forgot. Whoop, there it is.
Vader collides with
no,
Race.
You don't want to bring another
Steamboat
person
Race
into the
in.
Ring.
And Steamboat, like a wild man.
Oh, Vader.
Harley
got his just desserts.
This is a three-man battle royal.
You're right. Steamboat cannot fight both men for too long.
He's been in there quite a while, though, with both of them. He's taking what they wanted to give him.
Uh-oh.
This referee is just letting anything happen.
Just like they held.
Oh, okay.
They're calling for the ball.
Not anymore.
Coming in interference. Just like
I guess he heard me.
Super broad double teaming.
Oh no, the fucking cops are here. Boo.
What a cheap shot from
Boo.
Once again the Boss.
ACAB includes the Boss. That's not the Boss man. The Boss man wears blue. The Boss wears black. Whoop, there it is. All right.
No matter who you are,
whoop,
there
is
always a warrior deep within you.
waiting to break out.
Whoop, there it ain't.
Are you listening to me?
This was sent to me by Andrew Heelan like a year ago or something.
It is going to be sensational.
You don't need to tell me that, Harold.
Aroha.
You could pick on someone your own size.
What if I told you that you're Ansem Harold's real name weren't Harold at all?
Never have doubted you, Harold.
Colonial Combat, we'll all be watching that. There you go. Tell the tape.
As
Godzilla,
you can see,
one story.
His stature fairly
taller.
You know, Godzilla had the edge in fire breathing.
My grandpa's here, everybody.
But King Kong, he's got something to prove, you know, since his last appearance here in New York, where he was upset and he fell from the top.
Grandpa Lewis, there he is.
King Kong and Godzilla's guest manager.
He's everyone's grandpa.
Thanks, Grandpa. Let me tell you something, Michael.
Thanks,
hey,
Grandpa.
My man Godzilla's going to teach me how to breathe fire, and I'm going to teach him everything that the Midnight Express can do in the ring. What you got is a King Kong and dying old age. Godzilla's going to take it, brother.
Well, the first mistake Godzilla did was get a four-eyed sissy like you to manage him. Because you understand, the only thing Godzilla does when he gets mad is goes to Tokyo and stops our little Japanese people. King Kong has the ability to swap planes, trains, and still hold a woman in his arms. He's going to walk down Bad Street. What you think, Grandpa?
I got to get to a phone and get a hold of my bookie.
Right. You have Bonnie Blackstone along with Medusa Michelli. Medusa, I have a question for you.
Oh,
it would seem
wait,
obvious
on.
To our
God
fans that you enjoy
it,
toying
on,
with your opponents before you finish them off. Why?
Hold on. Oh, my most humblest apologies, everyone. This is this week's Necro Eric Vault match. If you don't know, I take submissions on this show. And a viewer of the show, Necro Eric, once sent in 1,490 matches. And we go through them one by one. And here's this week's.
Bonnie Blackstone along
we watched
with Medusa Michelli.
Versus
Medusa, I have a question
Nasty
for you.
Linda
it would seem obvious
week,
to our fans that you enjoy
to
toying with
this,
your opponents before you finish them off. Why?
This Medusa.
I don't toy with them.
streak, we're going.
It seems like you could finish off your opponents a lot quicker than you choose to do so.
Of course I could. But by punishing them, I teach them a lesson. Mm.
Tell me which of the LPWA stars impresses you here.
None.
None?
None. N-O-N-E. None.
Not even Terry Power, Lady X, Reggie Bennett, none of these?
Lady X. Okay,
believe
maybe Lady
it.
X.
Before long, they too will be taught a lesson, and they will call me Sensei.
Whoa.
Sensei. Medusa Michelli, a very serious opponent for a lot of the top stars here in the LPWA.
LPWA.
Fans, this bout is scheduled for a one fall. Introducing first from Milan, Italy, weighing 148 pounds, Medusa Michelli!
Wow, they
and
put
her
name
opponent
on there for
from
about a third
Valdosta,
of a second.
Georgia, weighing 140 pounds, Allison Royal!
Allison Royal.
Well, should be a great match here on the LPWA. Medusa Michelli taking on Allison Royal in our opening match. Some interesting comments by Medusa there in the tunnel with Bonnie Blackstone. And telling you, this woman, loonier
wow.
every week. That's
everything,
all I can say.
Everything that Medusa does is different. You can see right now she's got the Japanese-style boots on.
She used those in her full contact karate exhibitions as well as her wrestling competition. Now going for a big standing head scissors on Allison Royal. Medusa just very workmanlike, systematically taking Allison Royal apart at every
I
joint.
I love Medusa's outfit
piece.
With the
Zubaz. Medusa Michelli, one of the most experienced wrestlers in lady wrestling history. She has done it all.
Oh, brother, look at this. This is a submission maneuver.
Yeah,
oh, she rocks her back. The legs tied up.
And
got her around the neck.
A hell of a
I mean, she has
her.
Absolutely got her in every way you can think of and just lays her down. It's almost like she's looking at this as an exhibition or something, because she is just doing everything you can do to Allison Royal. But look at this. A beautiful move now by Royal. 1, 2. And Medusa kicks out, but Allison Royal shows
like
her
you,
that
Jack.
There is some life in there and that she's not going to put up with just being treated like a rag doll.
Royal now takes over on Medusa Michelli with the arm bar.
Wow.
Medusa is the people's champion, as her championship
interview
belt says.
Interview with Bonnie Blackstone later.
The people of Tokyo, Japan,
invented
presented
DoorDash
her just last
in
year in honor of her tremendous contribution.
Her and
to all
Joe
Japan women's wrestling
family lost a ton
she
of
left
money
the belt
running
with me
a business
for
where they
Joe, because
you
I'm the only honest person around here.
From the
so
local
think
restaurant of your choice, and then send a delivery driver
a wallet,
from their company
her championship
to pick up your order.
Near Medusa Michelli.
That's from not that Tom Green in the chat. Too big to share, but I thought I'd read it because that's interesting.
You know what? She's stranger than normal. Isn't it great Norman has the rabbit back?
Yeah.
Isn't it great?
Now,
chanting
they'll
for
both
Allison,
disappear from whence they came.
Think,
not to
ooh.
Bother innocent folks
look
again.
Look at this move count, by ref? Medusa.
Don't trust a ref
she had
with
her rolled up
hair.
And then just shoved her on over.
Royal goes in, gets the arm, twisting wrist lock, cranks up on it a time, takes it around the bend. Putting the elbows now to the joint, the shoulder joint. Medusa firing back with that chop. Medusa will she will just stun you right in the head, boy. I tell you, in about a half a heartbeat.
That's what she just did, too. She stunned Allison Royal. Now she throws her in, comes off with a clothesline, knocks her directly back into that turnbuckle again. Takes Allison now. Allison reverses it, throws her in, and
look at Medusa over the top rope.
Medusa
upside
doing a
down,
flare
blocks
thing.
A punt.
Oh.
Goes to the midsection.
Now
up on the rope.
Look at that.
Medusa rules.
Medusa
she can do it all.
Threw her halfway across
she
the ring.
She may be loony, but she's got some of the greatest moves I have ever seen in wrestling.
Going after that
and
arm,
now the arm
that gets
oh,
rolled
look
up
that
by
move
Allison
Royal.
Allison Royal almost surprised. Medusa Michelli with that crotch roll.
Almost a crotch roll.
Taking her back, sends her across. Big elbow right to the jaw.
Allison Royal, one of the most popular newcomers here in the LPWA.
Crotch
and Wally Carbo tells me that the fan mail for Allison is stacking up more and more every week. She takes on the toughest opponents in the LPWA because she says she wants to learn.
Whoa!
Now there is a spinning.
Well, she just
there's
caught her. She just caught her right there with the back of that heel right on the chin.
Allison Royal, though, had enough to kick out. I don't know how.
Two count only
for that had
karate.
To be from instinct.
That sweeping roundhouse kick, one of the most deadly maneuvers.
Where is she going now? She's up on that second rope. She's sitting there.
Whoa!
Gave her a drop kick, but Royal moves and Medusa goes down. Good moves by Allison Royal, but look at that by Medusa.
Two.
Medusa, small packages.
This is a way
Allison
more
Royal was able
match
to kick out.
I
beautiful
expected.
Moves here. Now, where is she going with this?
Ooh, Death Rider.
What a unique suplex. That one right
wheels
down on the back of the
two,
head.
Yep. Three count, that's it.
Right on the back of the head with that one. A power suplex from Medusa.
Here is your winner, Medusa Michelli.
What is that
LPWA
strut?
In one
well,
pay-per-view.
That's a strut. That's what that is. But I tell you, Medusa caught her.
It's not the old Jackie Fargo strut. And look at that.
Well, it's more of a strut that Don or Roughhouse Fargo might have done. And Medusa beginning to remind me of Roughhouse Fargo, but she caught her.
Please tell me why you sitting out here in this little baby fizzy pool for what? Why are you sitting out here in this pool when
more
I told
New Jack.
You
we saw New Jack
I need
last
you to
week.
Be scouting my matches tonight because you know what kind of matches I got coming up.
Not that
why
Tom Green sent
pool?
This one in.
The monitor what? I don't care. I need you to be out there scouting my mess. All right? It's Sandman and it's Sunny, and I need you to be watching because I got the match with him next week. All right? Look, I'm not playing in this little pissy pool with you. I'm not doing it. All right?
You get
not
in the
understand.
Pool, Jack.
Black people don't play in the water good. Black people don't do water good. The last time they put a bunch of us in the water, it was in a boat, and the ride wasn't no fun. I don't want to get in no water with
boy.
You.
Shark Boy looks away,
what
unsure
that?
What to say.
A damn octopus, and you want me to play with you?
A damn octopus.
You, Boy, I done beat your ass in every game that we done had. Now I gotta play a little octopus game. What I gotta do? Throw this to wet. I don't like this game. I gotta get in the water. Fuck. Now my draw's wet.
There you go. Oh, two for Thursday. Another not that Tom Green. We got Doug Furness and Phil LaFon versus Matt and Jeff Hardy with their tights that they made themselves. This is when Jeff Hardy was making their tights, sewing them. Probably get a little piece of trucker speed and sew outfits all night. Now my drawer's wet. I'm putting it down. It might make it. I don't want it to make it, but it might.
And speaking of Pursuit, Ken Shamrock still in pursuit of the WWF title. He's announced
I'm kind
he's
of leaning towards Whoop There It Ain't.
Enter the 1998 Royal Rumble to try to go through 29 other guys to
yeah,
get
I want to watch more Furness and LaFon in Japan. I have some earmarked for later.
In the corner of his brother Frank Shamrock, who goes after the UFC middleweight title, folks, at the Ultimate Japan pay-per-view from Yokohama, Japan on December 21st. He'll be battling Kevin Jackson, and we certainly want to wish Frank Shamrock the best of luck. That pay-per-view event
Shamrock.
Gets underway at 8 p.m. on the 21st. These Hardy boys, they will take any kind of risk. They'll pay any price to. What a springboard!
Oh, no!
Oh, how horrible. He went for the springboard moonsault and the rope went right out from under his feet.
Jeez, they're going to replay this? Oh, come on, poor guy.
Call it high risk.
Oh, he ate shit. Hard.
The back of Jeff Hardy's head.
Jeff.
And right now, he doesn't know where he is. He's taking his time, but he don't
this
know where.
This is amazing.
Well, it would appear to be academic. I'm assuring Phil LaFon will just cover Jeff, and that'll be the end of this matchup. But no, he's going to pick him up. And
the Hardy Boys, I remember this period when the Hardy Boys were jobbers that people got behind. They were great.
No,
they would be on the Mexican show.
Like I said,
that was Los Super Astros, which I used to watch. I love Los Super Astros. And
but more than that,
these guys would be on it for some reason, putting over Los Burritos and Pantera.
Two, and Matt in to make the save. I'm wondering maybe Jim's discretion, the better part of valor, should have let that three count just happen. Well, I'll tell you what, you know, a guy's got to have compassion for his brother, but his brother's still fighting. I don't believe this. Oh, bulldog, desperation move. Jeff Hardy needs to make a tag. He desperately needs a tag to his brother Matt. Because he has really been wounded. Furness and LaFon have a killer instinct now, unlike what they had when they first came here. Tag man,
right.
Here we go.
Yeah, I definitely want to see some real Furness and LaFon. I think I had, I've definitely had some matches of theirs lined up and cut them for time.
Matt Hardy now with a slam.
Just because they're like longer type matches.
He looks like he's
going
for a high risk move.
From the top rope, moonsault.
Cover, two.
A lot of surprises tonight.
From North Carolina.
We got commercials from the 90s. We got UFC being.
Whoa,
I love that!
Inverted splash. Jeff Hardy right back on the horse. Legal man, two. And Doug Furness in to break up the count. These guys are going after it. What a match. Jeff now.
Wow. Oh, no. Into the abyss goes Jeff Hardy. Wow, that was fun. That was a fun little match. Thank you, not that Tom Green. We are always taking submissions here at the potluck. Hit up my Gmail, prowrestlingpotluck@gmail, to send me matches or promos or ads, or if you have any ideas for a gimmick or whatever, send them to me, prowrestlingpotluck@gmail.
You can win Stone Cold Steve Austin's truck.
I was paid to promote Godzilla vs. Kong 14 months later. Thinking about putting the Juggalo episode on YouTube, I think that might get some new eyes. Because a lot of weird Juggalos came out of the woodwork when I was promoting that Juggalo thing. Wow, I didn't realize this is ripped from the headlines. Hell yeah.
待ち受けるのは重心サンダーライガーだ。バイオアーマーに身を包むのは引退後なんと初、読んで字のごとく獣の神。怪獣をゴジラを相手にできるのは世界の重心ただ一人であります。果たしてゴジラは人知を超越した能力で新日本プロレスに入団できるのか。
I love and respect the Juggalo. Here we goPalm strike to Godzilla.
初代ゴジラの新日本入団テスト見事合格すれば 7.2 公開ゴジラ VS コングの
PR だ。 When I was looking, I had this and I was looking to see if there's anything else. I learned that Jushin Liger is a huge kaiju fan and collects and paints little kaiju models and whatnot, which I think is very neat.
そして俺はゴジラの模型を作ってるからゴジラの
言
葉が分かるこの怪獣法が、もはや
サイバーに
生物学の常識は通用しないのでありましょうか。これぞ獣の神。ではクイズスタート。
第1問、コングとの決戦の地は。おゴジラ君、
ゴジラ、なんと答えた。
熱海ですが、
なんとのっけから引っ掛け問題。ライガー意地悪。お手つきした初代ゴジラ、
ゴジラ is getting hot, flipping the table.
熱海城からこれで落ちたあの屈辱が蘇ったか。
I haven't. I have not seen the MMA fight with Liger and Minoru
Suzuki. 今回の映画の決戦の地。
I can't believe Godzilla and King Kong are teaming up. Can they coexist?
映画の宣伝マン、あの手この手の番宣クイズは終幕。さあ最後の関門は戦慄の体力測定であります。
入門テスト、ヒンズスクワット。
お手本はなぜか棚橋博士。あ、ディレクターの
パソコンにたまたま素材があっただけで、
特に意味はないとの情報が今放送席に入りました。さあゴジラはどうか。
I like the noise of Godzilla doing a squat.
いとも簡単にこなします。調子に乗ったライガー、次に試すのはなんだ。なんとゴジラをハンマーするか。
Trying an Irish whip.
初代ゴジラの体重は2万トン、ライガー換算でなんと21万人分に相当いたします。
動かねえな、お前なんでだよ。
2万トンだからであります。さあ渾身の逆水平チョップも。
Oh, it hurt to chop Godzilla.
そしてこの攻撃がゴジラの怒りの導火線に火をつけてしまった。ゴジラ式新モンゴリアンチョップ決まった。グレートオーカンも天山ヒロヨシも真っ青。あー、ライガーに危険が迫る。危ない。そして出たゴジラ式ラリアット。
Godzilla.
それでも立ち向かうライガーにも一発。体重2万トンのゴジラがダメ、カウント。
ジューシュトンダーライガーが pinned by Godzilla。
1954時間11分3秒、初代ゴジラ新日本プロレス入団決定であります。
VS コング。
ゴジラが映画の見どころを説明中です。
Liger's putting over Godzilla before faces Kong.
守護神 Kong. 地球の存亡をかけたすげえすげえバトルが始まると言ってるよ。彼らはなぜ戦うの？ Kong とゴジラ最強はどっちだ？
刮目せよ驚異の戦術の一台。
Now this comes to us from Owen Straw, who's absent right now. I don't know where he is. I saw him earlier today. But he sent this in. We all know the Shockmaster going through the wall, but what happened to him after that?
Oh, well, Benny Mangini, I'm just excited to be here at WCW Saturday night.
What a Saturday night. We've got a brand new year. You've got a big year coming up.
Oh, I got a big surprise for you, though. Even more exciting. My best friend in the whole world. He's gonna come right here to WCW. He's the kind of friend that stands behind your back from thick and thin.
Whoa, don't keep this, don't keep us in.
He's got friends.
Let me tell you, he's the Super Shock Master.
The Super Shock. I have been informed just before going on the air, if you would, Shock Master, that we have standing by, via satellite, the man you refer to as the Super Shock Master. Whoa. Let's take a look.
Uncle Fred, I want to thank you very much.
He says Uncle Fred.
For inviting me here to the WCW. I know how much the little kids think of you and how much you think of them. But actually, I don't care what they think whatsoever.
This is bizarre.
The reason I've come to the WCW is to win matches. Thanks, Uncle Fred.
Whoa, I don't get that. All right, back into the action. This is from the Suzannimal. Adam Suzanne sent this one in.
Oh!
Pokotan の握手を拒否していきました、クリス・ブルックス。
Chris Brooks versus Pokotan.
スペシャルシングルマッチ15分1本勝負のスタートです。
All right.
お互いにちょっとファイティングポーズからロックアップに入りました。
A kaiju that was more dangerous than King Kong and Godzilla combined.
クリーンブレイクになるでしょうか。
We have this thing, Pokotan.
ちょっと挑発入ってますね。
ちょっとバフバフしてました、
はい。ちょっと小バカにしつつクリーンブレイクというね。
Getting a good sound out of that head.
秋山選手はこの一戦、はい、どんな戦いになると長い経験の中でちょっと予測してもらいたいんですが、
これどうなんですかね。予測。
予測と言いますか、そのまあ戦力の分析と言いますか。
はい、なかなか僕も。
Pokotan has a little attitude.
Pokotan 難しいですね。
Pokotan は難しい。過去にちょこっとだけ絡んだことありますよね。
ちょこっとですね。
Pokotan.
Oh! 結構強烈
だったね。Slap across the face.
お、これでクリスに火がついたか。Pokotan
ドロップダウン。Tries to trip Brooks. Doesn't work.
お、腰投げからカードガード。
These two are so evenly matched.
お、クロスジャンプ。
結構動けますね、ポコタン。
あ、ポコタンね、DDT 限定参戦ですからね。このチャンスに、ものにしたいでしょう。
ポコタン is in control. Brooks on the outside taking a breather. The crowd behind Pokotan. What's he gonna do? He's going for a dive. The big head. Stuck in the rope. Oh no.Brooks, is he going to take advantage? The referee is helping.
Oh,
big slap to the head of Pokotan.
Ah, the yellow, the yellow, the yellow, the yellow, the
yellow, the yellow, the yellow, the
yellow,
the yellow, the yellow, the yellow, the
yellow, the
あんまり激しくやられると 頭もげちゃったりとかなんかいろんな支障が。
そう。前もげましたから。
Into the guardrail, Pocatan. He's hurt. He's feeling it.
ちょっと瞳孔が開いています。
おお、he slaps him. Disrespect.
すごい音がします。
え、ちょっとこんなプレスないですよ。どうしたんですか、クリス。
厳しいっすよ。
何かこう。
Oh, head first into the ring post.
そうですね。
Pocatan's on Dream Street.
ああ、なるほど。
Brooks with the.
なるほど、DDT に可愛いは二人いらない。
Knee against the back.
ごめん、ごめん、ごめん。
謝りながらもひどいことをし続けるクリス・ブルックス。
Oh shit. Okay, is he dead?
Oh,
he's moving. He's moving.
入れるの大変ですよね。
Pocatan is still with us, folks.
入れない。
Having trouble throwing him back in the ring, that giant head.
わあ、もう、ああ、わかる、まずですよ、まずですよ。まずですよ。
どうさんがなんか泣きます。ああ、あれ。
ほら戻った。
Smashing the skull. Pocatan to get him.
ちょっと戻
ってないよ。
形状が戻らない。デスユニバースをご覧のちびっ子たち大丈夫です。側頭部がへこんだままなんじゃないですか。ポコタンの許容範囲です。
ね、ちょうどお正月でお家でお父さんお母さんとご覧になってるかもしれない。
Brooks in control. He's got that flipper.
これ尻尾なんですね。噛んでる
噛んでる
噛んでる。
Oh, he's biting it now.
尻尾ですよ。大丈夫です。
尻尾十字。
He's got that flipper. Pocatan signals no.
耐えてます。
Getting strength from these fans, these DDT faithful.
さあ、ポコタンこれはエスケープしたい。
尻尾にも当然関節はありますからね。
尻尾だった場合は関節はあるでしょうね。
尻尾ですと関節ありますね、はい、おかなり弱ってますよ。
どうしたんですか。
これでも
あちょっと力がありませんよ。力がないんだ。
ポコタンに反撃の力はどうやら
残っていない模様です。
ちょっと目が白目ですよ。
これはちょっとレグリーが危険と見なした場合はレグリーストップというものも考慮して。
Forearms have no effect.
Chop.
Same story. Oh.
容赦しません、クリス・ブルックス。
Reversal.
切り返したポコタン。
Oh no! Kicks the head off of Pocatan. You sick fucking
kid. これこの絵怖いですよ。
クリスの表情。
芯が見えちゃいました。
うわいや怖い怖い怖い怖い怖い。
逆です逆です。ちょっと慌ててますよ。
Head is on backwards. Pocatan.
口を開けて。
Oh man.
信じられないといった表情のクリス・ブレック
ス。動揺が。
実は見えて
た。No one home.
見えないふり作戦でしたね今ね。
本当ですね。ポコタン赤ちゃんなのに賢い。
さあこの時間帯をポコタンはうまく使っていきたい。ナックル、クリス・ブレックス。ハンマースロー。
おお、ビッグタイムヘッドバット from Pocatan。That head has taken a lot of damage, but I think it can.
おさあさっきは、
fans are ready for it.
やめた方がいいですよ。
トペスイシーダを。
We know he can't jump through the ropes.He's got to find a way through. Helpful referee.
はい、頭頂部治っていません。エプロン最後に
入れた。
クリス・ブルックスが場外に落とそうとしますが、これを拒否して。
In the guardrail, Pocatan. What's he doing? He's got plans. Make sure his head is on straight.
ちょっとちょっと。
What is he doing?Okay, I thought he was going to do a moonsault. I was getting very afraid. From the second rope splash! Don't lose your head! Pocatan!
Pocatan has 120 kilos. It's very hard.
Hey, Chris, it's
okay.
It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay.
It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. It's
getting fired up. This is the ultimate Pocatan now.
たっぷり溜めてます。
あのぷよぷよしたところが脂肪なんですよね。蓄えてますね。
Shaking the guardrail. Hell we guess.
これはポコタン、ちょっと面白い展開になってまいりました。
だから入れないっていうね。ポコタン結構出たり入ったりしますね。
He can't get back in.
ちょっと爆笑しましたね。
おお。
自力でリングインです。 ホイップ。ボコタン、串刺しラリアット。
クローズラインインザコーナ
ー。さらに、しかし、
頭。
Hell of a drop kick, two feet almost in the eyeballs of Pokatan.
Damage はありますが、形は元に戻
ります。Going for the pin.
無理やり体固め。クリス・ブルックス、ポコタン2で返します。
Two count only. A bit of a slow count if you ask me, but no one did.
ちょっとこれポコタンね。過去に例がない。
Brooks signaling the end, perhaps.
ロングマッチになり。
Getting that big head between his legs, looking for.
さあ、ポコタンに対してプレイングマンティス。打たせません。
Forearm. Ooh, boo.
Yay.
なんか頭に食らうと中の脳みその部分にかなりダメージがありそうですよね。
揺れますね。
Oh, shot right to the nose.
お前やりやがったな、トポコタン。連続エルボー。しかし顔面蹴り、ポコタン倒れない。
ポコタン、
ポコタン、ポコタンドロップキック。ポコタンのドロップキック。そしてポコタンなんだ。まさか。
あ、
ポコタンメーカ
ー。
ポコメーカーポーズ。
レインメーカー。They didn't do the camera angle. They
イワシですかね。
They missed it.
あ、クラッチしましたよ。
そして
Getting him up. Rip cord. Oh, headbutt.
レインメーカー式のヘッドバット。
これなんか、あれ、こんなやる人いますよ。
これ横くすぎですね。
Getting his knee ready for big knee.
ポコ越えですね、きっとね。
ポコ越え、ポコ越え。
ポコ越えね。
ポコ越え。
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 さあ、決めるか。
It might be it. Cranium cruncher.
Count two. ちょっとすごくないですか。いろんなものが憑依してますよ。
本当ですね。なんか非常になんかこう年明けっぽい感じ。
エアギターですよ。エアギターですよこれ。
ギターも弾くんだ。
Go Ace。
ちょっと一足早いじゃないですか。
Got that air guitar. Throws it away.
ギター投げてからの。
Sling blade! Don't lose your head! Pokatan with the sling blade on Chris Brooks! Doesn't take advantage!
こうなったら次何が出てくるのか気になっちゃいますよね。
当てたいですね、次何出るかね。なんかコーナーを刺しましたよ。あー、これね、一気に飛び越えたい。
ピョーンと飛び乗りたいんですね。飛び乗りたいんですね、これね。
まあ、棚橋選手がね、飛ぶときはね、
言いましたね、
一足飛びに、このエントリーに出るのがこだわりですから。
棚橋選手の場合はね。
棚橋選手の場合はですね。
今、拍手を来ましたよね、飛び越えたら。
これ来た。これ、フラ
ッパー。これ大丈夫ですか、これ。
いろいろ危ないですよ。
Got him butterflyed up, and...
ダブルアーム!
Suplex! Head rolls!Helpful referee.
さすがにもうポコタンも限界か。いやーポコタンもかつてないほどの奮闘プリを見せましたが、クリス・ブルックス。
Big time drop kick from the top rope right to the head of Pokatan.
なんかもうボロボロですよ。
ボロボロですよ。
ダウンカウント、松井レフェリーダウンカウントを取ります。カウントは10まで
待ってほしい。
もう後頭部は元戻ってますからね。
よかったよかった。
ポケタン、ゴー。クライム、you're up! He's up! He's up! Oh, he's actually not up. I thought he was up.Still got some fight left in him. Don't give up on Pokatan, folks. Do not give up.
クリスも困ります
ね。15
分一本勝
負。そうでした。
クリスも攻め疲れじゃないですかね。
Boots right to the forehead. Oh, right to the side of the head.
蹴られながらもポコタンはそのファイティングスピリットを燃やし続けます。
Oh, catches the boot.
なんだ。
Puts it down.
おお。これは
Double bird。
どっかで見たような。
You ever seen an otter give double birds?
ちょっと立ち乗りましたね。
そうですね。
Reversal. Pocatan in the ropes. Drop kick to the knee of Brooks.
Oh!
Help the dragon screw leg whip. You ever seen an otter do a dragon screw?
まさかの。この頭で。指が。これももう明日っちゃ明日ですよね。明日とか明後日とか。
そうですね。
場所も同じですね。場所も同じ。
Feeling himself lining up the shot.
クレームに収まった。あ、カウンターのジャンピングに。
He's knocked out. He's got him up. Shit, sits out with it.
ここはクリスがポコタン。
Brooks a jerk. Chris Brooks just picks up the head of Pocatan.
プレイングマンティスボムだけは許さないということがなんだ。クリスがトップコーナーに上がりますよ。
クリスなんかコメントします。
クリス・ブルックスの、
ああ、ダブルスタップ on the head。 There's a crater in the head of Pocatan. I think he's never gonna be the same again.
止めた。
He's dead. He's never gonna be the same. Wow. Well, that was from the Suzanimal. Thank you very much.
All right, we've seen this man on the interview on WCW Saturday night.
Back to the Super Shockmaster.
The Super Shockmaster, and I can tell you, you're nothing like the man that we know as the Shockmaster here in WCW.
Exactly. Any resemblance to the Shockmaster and myself is strictly coincidental. You know, I want to clear something up. The fact that he's a big, strong, incredible individual.
This is...
And the fact that we're both named...
This is so whack.
...the Shockmaster are the only...
He sounds like Heaven from The Office.
And another thing that I want to clear up is about this big man who calls himself Vader. I hear he thinks he's the biggest, the strongest.
Super Shockmaster's got a big,
the toughest man,
pot of beans
in the WCW. Well, he hasn't.
Yeah, he
met the
Shockmaster that we know, the Goof. He introduced his friend, Super Shockmaster. Yeah.
No doubt about it, the powerful Super Shockmaster is here in World Championship Wrestling. Fans, will be back right after this timeout.
Oh, hey, what? Whoa, okay. A couple things we got to go over before we get to the main event. First of all, if you don't know, these shows, after I'm done with them, after they're live on Twitch, they go into the archive, which you can just click on my link tree. It's all the old episodes. I'm starting to put them on YouTube, and it's been fun to see new people watch them through YouTube. And last week, as we signed off, I had people guess. We guessed what was going to be cut from last week's episode on the YouTube cut. The two things that were cut from last week's episode was the promo of Mr. Perfect playing chess, which somebody did predict, and the main event was cut from YouTube because it's New Japan and they don't want people to see things. So, knowing that, what's going to get cut tonight, folks? What's going to get cut from tonight's show, if anything? Sometimes nothing is cut. So we'll find out. We have, I think, one last match. Another BuzzBen. People are talking about this on Twitter today. I saw this on Twitter, so let's hit that beautiful BuzzBen footage.
In the future, everything will be simple. With just a look and a thought, anything can be yours. Looking further.
We have always been down.
Deeper. Longer. Into the buzz.
All right, here we go. Here's our main event of the evening.
I got some unfortunate news.
Unfortunate news.
My opponent didn't show up tonight.
His opponent didn't show up? Wait, is that the... That's the Fiend. It's the Fiend. He's back. It's Bray Wyatt, the Fiend.
What the heck? Would it be Bray Wyatt?
One man crew. Looks like he's his opponent didn't show up. He's got the Bray Wyatt, the Fiend. He's back. The Fiend is back, and he's at this outdoor show. Oh, the Fiend taken down.
It's over. It's over.
My God. Okay. All right. That main event was pretty short. So we have a standby match. Because that match was so short, we got a standby match. And we're going to go to that. And that will be our main event. This is a submission from Owen Straw, the man who makes this music. Check him out on SoundCloud. Here is our actual main event, folks. Let's go to it right now. All right.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, your main event of the evening, a non-title match between the Pro Wrestling Guerrilla World Champion, Walter.
Ladies and gentlemen, belt number 7 is your main event, and it is a non-title match. Set for
Brody King, that's another microphone from Christian Cole.
Put the mic down, Brody.
Walter, I have the utmost respect for you.
Shut up.
And I have the utmost respect for this company.
Shut up.
But if you want to prove that you're the ring general, and you're one of the best in the world, why don't you put that belt on the line?
Brody King trying to talk himself into a Pro Wrestling Guerrilla World Championship title match. And it looks like he's done so. Walter on the spot. Agreeing to defend the title for the second time.
Ladies and gentlemen, belt number 7 is your main event of the evening. And it is for the Pro Wrestling Guerrilla World Championship. Challenger, wrestling out of Van Nuys, California. Weighing in this evening at 275 pounds, this is Brody King!
Brody King making his Pro Wrestling Guerrilla debut short months ago and now finds himself in a World Championship title match.
Wrestling out of Vienna, Austria. Weighing in tonight at 136 kilos. He is the Pro Wrestling Guerrilla World Champion, the Ring General, Walter!
Walter, the aptly named Ring General. Your champion, but if Brody King has anything to say about it, not for much longer. Walter and King met in tag team competition for the first time at the first night of All-Star Weekend 14 earlier this year. And it was a hoss fight.
All right.
Brody King and Tyler
Ready
Bateman.
Ready for this. Our main
Taking
event went short, so we got this standby match from Cool Dude
and
Food,
Walter.
Owen Straw, who is in
Violence
the chat,
Unlimited
ladies
versus
and
Ringkampf.
Gentlemen.
Ringkampf coming away with a victory. Oh, look at this. Brody King hesitated for a moment. Walter
fires in with that chop. Those deadly, deadly chops of Walter. Strike fear in even the sternest of wrestlers. I think even Penta El Cerro M might have some second thoughts.
I like that this is
Walter winding up for
this is PWG that isn't so old that I'm worried about the commentary having King goes for the straight up trip,
hits the
drop
kick on Walter. Takes the champ off his feet and then springs back up to a vertical position.
Hell of a show so
side
far.
Side headlock applied by Walter.
It will live
Brody
in the archive
the
and
again.
On YouTube. Leapfrogs
over Walter.
Gonna
Brody
try
hits
and
the
put them both up this
cross.
Weekend.
No.
It all depends.
King lands on his feet, ducks the chop. King with a chop of his own.
Ooh.
Tremendous athleticism by Brody King. But as this match wears on, will King be able to maintain the athletic advantage? Or will his size deplete his reserves? Greco-Roman knuckle lock. These two men will also be competitors in the 2018 Battle of Los Angeles. Remains to be seen which one of them walk into the tournament as Pro Wrestling Guerrilla World Champion. After this, they could be limping into the tournament as Walter sweeps out the leg of Brody King.
The bad news, folks, the bad news is that Rick Knox is our referee.
Walter forcing Brody to carry all his weight on the brick. Oh!
Oh! They look like the throat.
As Brody King was bridged back, his head firmly planted in the center of the ring. Walter just stomping him on the bottom of the jaw. But that's what makes Walter so dangerous. Truly the ring general. Oh! Thudding chop across
all those
the
professional
chest.
Fan types should all be
as he now
up.
Brings him through the ropes.
Oh!
Walter, for a third consecutive time, chop across the chest. Brody tried to get his hands in the way. But Walter is committed to a course of, oh! Walter has the chop caught. King, oh! Chop of his own!
Jeez! Sounds like gunfire.
Brody King just lighting up Walter. Oh.
Walter missing with his chop.
Walter, though, firing back with elbow strikes. The cravat applied brings King down to the mat and then stomped him on the side of the head.
Walter is one of those people, it's so funny that he's like in good shape
in
and everything now, and everybody's mad about
when Brody
it.
King
you don't see that
chopping up. Walter.
Right, he's like, no,
Walter
I like you better
Brody
when you were
in the
fat.
Face. So you
Why
saw
can't you
Brody
be fat again, Walter?
Tried to block high. But instead, Walter countered with some elbow strikes to the side of the head. Reversal in the corner.
I haven't
Banderas
seen any
Brody over
Gunther.
The top. Walter blocks the elbow or the punch attempt. And now Walter with a chancery on Brody. Got him draped into the neck breaker. It was almost a neck breaker DDT combination.
What's the name of this this building? That is a great look.
This is
I know
the
their
second
old
time
spot is legendary and is
found
now
one
a
another.
Parking lot or something, but this is a
found
good
each other
spot.
Across the ring from one another.
Well, I think Andrew Hewlett has
and right
solved
now
the
it's
mystery.
Proceeding very similarly
of why
to how
people don't like Gunther being in shape.
Some flashes from Brody King, but Walter
Brody King
convincingly dominating. Oh, big elbow strike knocking the champion back. Flying mare sends him down, and Walter, oh, cranking on the neck of Brody King.
Walter looks funny when he does that because he's like a big old dude, and then it looks like he does a little dance.
The thing to watch here theater, is beautiful. What lessons did Brody King take away from that match with Walter?
I want to go to some damn West Coast shows
How
someday.
How is he going to counter the unrelenting assault from the Ring General?
Ah.
And now Walter just manipulating the head and neck of Brody King. You can see Brody actually hanging onto the hands of Walter to try to prevent him from taking the head, taking his head off. And King shot to the midsection, trying to.
Matt McCarthy's easy to find in
fight
these
his
crowds.
Way back. Went for the dropkick.
Bearded
Walter.
Redhead.
Just catches it and steps over into a Boston Crab. Walter got his hands up. He blocked the dropkick.
WrestleMania weekend in New Orleans. I sat behind Dave Meltzer.
Knocks it aside.
For Will
but immediately
Ospreay versus Matt Riddle.
Boston Crab. Now
and it was very funny.
Into the STF to step over
to an empty seat next to him that had his laptop on it.
Walter releases the leg.
And he couldn't get anything done because people kept bothering him and talking to him. And
to make it to the bottom.
It's very funny to see everyone go nuts because Dave Meltzer was watching this match with him.
Brody King getting the hometown reception. Van Nuys just.
That's the same WrestleMania weekend and the same day that I got a picture with the great Sasuke.
Not too far.
And my fiance said that's the most respect she's ever seen me show another person.
Walter just leans in.
When I got my picture taken with the great
Sasuke
and told him how long I've watched him and how much I love him.
Making his in ring return to action at Basket of Glory. Officiating the main event.
Getting uppercut.
As Sammy Guevara challenged Walter, and Walter just turning
Sammy
Guevara
challenged Walter
into ground
he must have
beef,
called Walter fat.
A fate that Brody King has thus far avoided, but as this match
I haven't seen any Gunther, man, but I think
makes
I'll
me
watch
immediately
Gunther Nakamura.
A lightning strike jump behind Brody King's back into the sleeper hold. Now butterfly suplex.
Big time butterfly.
As Walter hoists over King.
God.
They had two count.
Oh, I thought that match was going to have a rematch or something on a pay-per-view. That's what I meant. I thought they were doing it again. I have no time for WWE television.
Walter taking the measure of the challenger. Bringing him up to his feet. A lot of weight to move around.
I remember that. That was for like the on sale.
Brody King to move around.
Yeah, that was like the on sale.
A suplex attempt.
Thing.
Brody counters a suplex attempt with one of his own. And it was not an attempt, it was a
I
success.
I can't imagine cheering for a politician,
taking over the
especially
top.
One that would show up at WWE.
Brody up to his feet, backing Walter into the ropes. Chops. Brody ducks the chop attempt by Walter. Ducks the lariat attempt. Brody, three consecutive chops. You can see the chest of Walter welting and reddening.
Welting and
oh! Walter charges in with an elbow strike to Brody King
big
as he gets
elbow
broke.
Strike.
Oh, drop toehold onto the middle rope. Brody King hits the ropes. Cannonball set down on Walter.
Walter's got to think
he
about
was
that cannonball
the
sent
rope.
On.
Walter
Brody
on the
King's
outside.
Not giving
Brody
him
King.
Any time to think.
Toe base, Jesus. Cena. Over
illustrated
500
missile.
Pounds of human mass. Crashing into the floor here.
I remember I went to a Raw and I lost my voice booing a video of Puff Daddy. They put a video of Puff
Both men
Daddy on and I booed until I lost my damn voice. And I think I tried to start a You Killed Biggie chant. my You Killed Biggie chant did not catch on at Barclays Center.
Seven of the 20 counts. Didn't quite see the landing, but as I mentioned, that is a ton of mass. Not a literal ton, but it is a lot of mass to have flying at you and then to drive you into the floor. It's like Walter stirring as
Puff
his
Daddy King. Magic. Puff Daddy Magic, right on the list.
14 on the count from Knox. Elbow
I don't think it has
Walter.
Too much to do with the show, but I don't think that matters.
Oh,
I really
wow.
think Whoop There at 8 is going to be the episode of tonight's
Walter
program.
Battling a 90 count and then make it into the ring. They finally, finally pulled out
their
laser-like focus on one another. Walter,
as you said, I do have a long-standing feud with Sean Combs.
Don't think Walter actually landed a chop this entire match.
Oh,
that
no,
could be
a
game changer. Now the sleeper hold. Walter cinches it in. Brody grabs the ropes. Walter breaks. Go behind by Brody King.
Oh.
Deadlift
German.
Only a one count, but Brody King down
hard on
the back of his head.
Too much damage to keep the bridge going.
And Walter, now
beating
just
the chest.
Landing the chops, and now the sleeper applied as
Big,
Brody King
centered
the ring. Three rapid-fire chops. Brody escapes the hooks of Walter and then rolls to the ropes, forcing Walter to break the sleeper hold. You can see Brody still clutching his head. Landing awkwardly on the German he attempted, and now landing awkwardly on the German by Walter. Walter, Lariat obliterates him. One, two, no, Brody King kicks out. Brody once again clutching at his neck as Walter picks him up. Oh, no! Brody escapes out. Elbow strike hits the corner. Walter, huge shotgun drop kick!
Jesus Christ, Walter is so great. I miss him.
Now wrenches him up. Pow! Bomb! One, two, no! Brody kicks out. Walter, though, you can see adjusting his grip. STF! He's got the leg captured and now wrenching back on that injured neck of Brody King. Brody, though, makes it to the bottom rope, forcing the break by Walter. Brody King. Facing an extremely uphill climb. Walter with a significant experience edge. And right now, Walter with a functional neck as he hammers in those elbow strikes to the side of the head of Brody King, but you can see he's got that left arm of Brody captured so he could pull him into those elbow strikes. Now releases the grip.
Walter
Brody
losing a little
behind.
Of his strength. Oh, never mind.
Mimicking Walter's favorite pose.
Oh.
And Walter just teeing off on the face and DDTs him down. After the chop, one, two, no,
Why
Brody
would
kicks
you
out.
Why make Walter mad? Why?
It is mid-July here in Los Angeles, California. Reaching upwards of 90 degrees here. And while there is some ventilation, it is exceedingly warm here. And so imagine these two men carrying around all that weight, and in some cases, the weight of the other man. How that would affect their cardiovascular conditioning, not to mention those chops. just knocking all the air out of the lungs. Brody clutching his chest. And Walter taunting him now. Brody and Walter locking eyes,
Brody
champion
King
and challenger.
Brody King is great, man. I like seeing him against Moxley on AEW. That was cool.
Brody lighting up Walter with those chops. These two men brutalizing one another with chops. Walter with a high kick, catching Brody on jaw. Loving shot across the shoulder blades. Walter hits the rope. Yes! Brody has him up, fireman's carries. Plants him down. Cradle shock, one, two, no, Walter kicks out.
I legit think Taz and Excalibur are my favorite announce team.
Brody
great. Taz
is
great. Taz adds a whole lot.
He planted him down hard. Going for that low trajectory pile driver. Walter's
love the fight
got
feed.
Up
got
on the
blast the fight can, feed.
Oh, not air raid crash, air raid neck breaker.
Air raid neck breaker.
And now
breaker.
Walter bringing Brody King up to his feet. Lariat!
Big stiff lariat.
One, two, no, Brody
two,
King kicks out.
Two.
Walter
is our main event, folks. I guess actually our main event was one man crew versus some idiot dressed as the Fiend, and this is a match we had.
Walter in disbelief, now slicing himself up, bringing himself.
Old man Walter, my first time seeing Walter live was Janela's Spring Break.
The Pro Wrestler Gorilla
Walter versus
World Championship PCO, title still.
And it blew my
mind. He thought that was it. He thought his night was over. But Brody King.
Yeah. Fiend versus Pocatan. I'm going
to
be playing that on 2K22.
Resilient.
Ooh, I don't own it. I wish I owned it. Wish I owned it without paying for it.
Brody firing back with an elbow strike of his own. A chop. Elbow. Chop. Lariat. Loving Walter on the side of the head.
Lariat.
Brody hits the ropes. Oh, my God. Lariat across the face. Walter bringing him up to his feet. Got him on the shoulder. Oh!
Wow.
Sit out, tubes. Pile driver, one, two, three. That is it.
Yeah,
Walter.
I saw him at that show. Okay, yeah.
Retain.
I was at that show.
Here is your winner.
There's that light.
And still, Pro Wrestling Gorilla World Champion, the Ring General, Walter.
That progress show.
Walter retains.
That progress show
World
was 5 years ago.
And heads into the battle.
5 years ago last
champion.
Week or something. That
this
was a wild show.
This is Pro Wrestling Gorilla.
There was sweat, literally sweat dripping from the ceiling. Or condensation from sweat. All right, great match. Let's go back to the beach for the goodbye. Wow, that was a hell of a potluck. Thank you, everyone, for watching the damn thing and doing the damn thing and hanging out. The chat was a blast, as always. Always taking submissions. If you see down there, prowrestlingpotluck@gmail.com. And speaking of submissions, next week, next Thursday, is a full-on gimmick episode. It is the second annual Labor Day salute to the occupational gimmick. So we got some fun things next week. Still taking submissions for that. If you have a good match, a good occupational gimmick, especially one from not the United States, that would be fun. But I got some stuff, so we're going to have fun. I'm also working on a video game episode that I worked on the video game episode more this week than this episode. That probably shouldn't say that, but yes. So I'm taking submissions for that. What else? This will be on YouTube. Follow me on YouTube, please. Mr. Green Mist on YouTube. I'm putting these things up. I'm also putting up matches and promos and stuff that aren't on YouTube if I can. So, give me a follow. Thanks, everybody. Is anything else? Oh, I have homework. I'm on a podcast. You know, sometimes podcasts give you homework. I'm going to be on Contesting Wrestling again. And
We're going to be talking about the CM Punk versus Samoa Joe trilogy. And so I have to watch all those matches. So if I'm watching those matches over the weekend or in the coming weeks, because I don't know when I'm doing the show, I might just throw them on Twitch. I might just watch them on Twitch, Punk versus Joe. So, you know, if you get a little alert that I'm online, my Twitch is online, it's because I might be watching that. So join me for that if you want. Thank you so much, everybody. This was a blast. This was fun. No technical problems. I cannot believe that. That was great. Gamerdocious, you're here right in time for the very end. But hey, if you missed the show, it's going to be on YouTube in the coming days and also in the archive. Check the link tree. Please follow me, Mr. Green Mist. I have been Scotland Green. You have been fantastic. I'm going to eat some spaghetti right now, and I didn't really pick a song to take us out, so let's go to the hits. Let's go to The Great Texan by Terry Funk. We love that one over here, so we're going to go to that. Thank you, everybody. Good night. Where's that thanks for watching screen?
So sad. People think I'm so mean. My heart is soft and sweet, but I'm still a fighting machine.
Sweet with a warm, kind heart, but when I'm doing it in the rain,